When you saw the thumbnail, your immediate reaction was probably along the lines of, life on the sun? What is this bull? But hear me out. As weird as it might sound, there is actual substance to this seemingly absurd statement. Or not. Our current view of life is that it evolves under certain conditions that were favorable in our evolution. A world with liquid water, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and so on. The general consensus is that if extraterrestrial life exists, it must resemble life on Earth to some extent, meaning that it's governed by the biochemistry of proteins, nucleic acids, and fats. At a very basic level, the creation and preservation of life can be thought of as a cycle. DNA encodes proteins, proteins help DNA to self-replicate, DNA encodes proteins, and so on. This cycle can be self-sustaining or alive, as long as self-replication of the information carriers, like DNA, is faster than its destruction. Mutations of these information carriers then allow evolution to more complex species through natural selection. This formulation of life is a little unconventional. For example, it doesn't really draw a distinction between bacteria and viruses, although we generally consider viruses to be dead and bacteria to be alive. However, this all comes down to philosophy, and in the end, there isn't really a correct answer. So if you accept this unconventional formulation of life as a self-sustaining cycle with mutations leading to more and more complex life forms, then any system that allows such a cycle to exist allows the existence of life. In order for life as we define it to spawn, a system must meet the following conditions. First, the system needs to allow encoding of information, which is done through DNA in our case. Secondly, the system needs to allow these information carriers to self-replicate faster than they disintegrate. And lastly, the presence of free energy needs to be high enough to compensate for the loss of entropy caused by self-replication. In other words, the system needs enough available energy. If you can prove that these three hypotheses hold, then you've proven that life is possible, not just on the sun, but anywhere where these requirements are met. Now, the question you've all been waiting for, does a place like the sun meet these conditions? No, probably not. There's a relatively short paper arguing that these three conditions could be met, but it would require the existence of cosmic strings and magnetic monopoles, two purely hypothetical concepts interacting to form DNA-like information carriers. It might be possible, but very improbable. Even though life on the sun might be unlikely, we saw that every system that satisfies these conditions allows life to exist. This isn't a guarantee, however, at least not for advanced life like our own. This can be explained by the great filter hypothesis, suggesting the existence of barriers hindering natural evolution itself. These barriers could be placed anywhere along the evolutionary track. It could be that the formation of a very primitive self-replication cycle is already very difficult, or the jump to intelligent life could be near impossible, or it could be that all intelligent life tends to die out. The point is that there are a lot of ways to mess up the formation of life. It's reasonable to assume that the life that evolved on our planet had a relatively low barrier to entry, because if it didn't, other life forms with a lower barrier to entry would have likely formed. This means that there could be a different type of life form with a bigger barrier to entry, something that requires some intermediate steps that weren't possible before, something like an artificial intelligence that has the ability to evolve and self-replicate. In this case, we could function as a stepping stone or a jumping off point for this new, bigger and better form of life to come into existence. Of course, this is all just hypothetical. The complex nature of life makes it basically impossible to accurately predict if certain conditions will lead to life developing. The only thing we can reasonably do right now is speculate. And as proof of that, here's a video I made where I argue for the exact opposite viewpoint, that all intelligent alien life is likely very similar.